Hey mates, I'm Alex.
And I'm Gaston.
Welcome to Powered Mates.
This is the place to learn and share about Fabric and Power Platform. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this channel with your friends and colleagues.
So, hello again, Power Mate. Today, we are going to show you how to invoke a Databricks notebook from Power Automate.
That sounds great, but a couple of things. First thing first, you need to have a Databricks workspace. Then you need a cluster, a notebook to run that one, and make sure your notebook is safe and is configured to do what you need. In this case, let's head over to my machine so we can share a little bit of those kind of pre-requirements in some sense. So in this case, you can see that I have my Azure portal, and within my Azure portal, in my case, of course, the name is PowerMates Databricks. That is our service that we spin up in a resource group. And in the right corner here, you can check a couple of things. You know, we have the resource group in our case, and then this URL that is the URL of our workspace on the Databricks set of things. Then what I'm going to be doing is hitting this option here to launch our workspace. So when I hit this option here, it's going to open a new window to launch our Databricks workspace. And within the Databricks, we can start exploring. For example, I already have this notebook up and running here. That is the one that I'm going to share in this case. You can also, of course, hit in the left pane here, the workspace. So you can click on your workspace and you can open the workspace on this one. And this notebook is kind of simple notebook. You can check on this one and you can see that we are going to be loading data from a public blob storage. And then from that blob storage, we are going to be writing a new table as a delta in, and the name is going to be dim customer table. That is all that our notebook is going to be run. And then now Alex is going to be showing the magic behind the scenes, how Power Automate can invoke this notebook.
Yeah, that's right. A well-prepared notebook is the first step, you know, to be prepared. So the next step is to open Power Automate and create a new flow. So let's head over to my machine. As I mentioned before in other videos, this is the homepage for Power Automate. And maybe you already know, but that may or may not know, is like on Power Automate flows have like a bunch of different trigger actions. So that means that a Power Automate flow could be triggered depends of different actions. Could be because of an email arrives to an inbox, because item was created on a SharePoint list, something happened on SQL, or even a Power BI dataset was updated. These are different kind of triggers that you can use in Power Automate. In that particular case, I'm going to use an instance Cloudflow just for demo purpose. But again, you can use different kind of triggers to run a Power Automate flow, and maybe you find more interesting to run a Databricks notebook after something happens in other environment. Okay, so let's create the flow here using the manually trigger flow. And the important thing is here is how to invoke the Databricks notebook. So there's not an official on some point. There's not a connector from Databricks that you can use to invoke the Databricks API. So you need to use the HTTP action or connector to do that. So let's add an action. Let's start here HTTP. As you can see here, we have the HTTP action. So let's select the single HTTP. Of course, you can use HTTP plus Swagger or a webhook if you need to point for sample. But let's use the HTTP. And here we have a couple of parameters that we need to fill, you know, like fill in the blanks to call the Databricks notebook. The first of all is fill the URL, the URI. So you need to use the Azure Databricks instance to call your Databricks notebook. So the URL need to have on this particular format. You need https://databricks instance. That is something that you can get from your Databricks portal. On the top in your URL, you're going to find the Databricks instance. Then is .azuredatabricks.net/api/2.0/shops/run/submit. This is because it's the Databricks API. Okay, that's the first thing that you need to have. Is like, again, https://databricks instance. That is the need that what you need to fill, Databricks instance, and that then is just azuredatabricks.net/api/shop/run/submit. Okay. The second is a method, because we are going to call Databricks notebook. It's a post. Because on some point, maybe you want to send some parameter to, so that need to be a post, okay? The second and the third one, but this is an important one, is the authorization. One of the headers should be the authorization, okay? Is the authorization one. And then you need to build the Databricks PAT token with that format. Let me add here the format that should be barrier and the Databricks PAT token. You can find the Databricks PAT token going to your user on the right side of the screen on the Databricks portal. User settings, developer, and then you can create new token and you can find out the token. Okay, so that is the format, barrier, and the Databricks token, okay? And then the last point that you need to add, or the last parameter you need to add, is the body, okay? The body of your invocation, your call, need to have the cluster ID and the notebook path, okay? So the cluster ID, again, you can find the cluster ID on your Databricks portal, and then the notebook path, the same. You go to your notebook, where you have your notebook, click on the three dot and see path, and you're going to find the right path for your notebook. And then the run name, you don't need to change the run name, but if you want to put run Alex or run number two or whatever, you can edit here and add your run name, because with that run name is what you're going to find on your run shelf in the Databricks portal. You can quickly find with the run shelf because of the run name, okay? So let me change here because I have already one created. So I can show you how that looks like. So you can see here, I have the URL with the instance already here. So it's the instance and the Azure Databricks. Let me put here, okay? This is the important part, your instance. Then it's just the URL for the API. Then in the authorization one, you have to grab that token, that is the authorization token. And then on the body, you need the cluster ID and the notebook path. And then the run name, as I mentioned before, I just replaced for run mate. You can add whatever you want. So let's test it and see how it works. So if you're pretty new on Power Automate, after you save your flow, you can come here on the top right side and click on test here and test your flow and see how it works. Click on manually. Click on test and run flow. And after that, the flow should run and see what successfully or failed. In our case, was successfully. And we can check that the HTTP result was the status a status code 200, and even in the body of the response, you can find the run ID. So with that run ID, you can call another Databricks API endpoint, again, get extra information or complementary information about your run shelf. Okay? So let's head over to Gaston and see how it's look for the Databricks side of things.
Yep, right on. So in our Databricks workspace, we can check a couple of things. First of all, in the left pane here, you're going to have these shop runs under the Data Engineer stream. So if I click on the shop runs, you can check. And as we can see, Alex ran his Power Automate flow and was succeed as the status there. And if we click on this one, it's going to be opening the output of our notebooks. And as we mentioned before, we are calling kind of a, from a data frame, reading the data from a blob storage. And this is our blob storage, kind of a public one. And then after that, we are getting a table here and saving that as a delta table in our workspace. We can check, of course, go into the table itself, and in that table you can, as you can check on this one, this is our table, and I'm gonna be running kind of a select statement on this one, and all the results, they are coming directly after that show of runs from Power Automate. So this is pretty much to control and see that everything is running and was kind of pretty much invoked in the right way from Power Automate.
Yeah, that's right. And as I mentioned before, you can start imagining that there's a different use case to use Power Automate and trigger and call and invoke a Databricks notebook. You can maybe another use case, you can maybe you are working in a Power App, so maybe you can call the Power Automate flow and run a Databricks or something like an email, or probably you can imagine different use case that you can start using the HTTP call to run a Databricks notebook.
Stay tuned for more in-depth insights, tutorials, and exciting news here in our channel.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, and join us on this journey.
Together, let's unlock the full potential on Power Platform and Microsoft Fabric.
Yeah.